Wendy, we spend so much time in the community garden weeding. I mean, we have to have a roster so that people come in and do the weeding so that we can keep on top of it. But I see that you've got a lot of weeds through here. How do you manage it?
Yeah, I mean, good question. And it is a big issue for people, weeding. The reason why I've got them here is because this is a farm, and I've got a lovely shade tree here that's just coming back into leaf again. Mm-hmm. And so what has happened here over the years is the cows have come in here and spent too much time in here and basically have compacted the soil and degraded the soil. And we're starting to get the vegetation coming in. We're starting to get a bit of grass, but we've still got the weeds in here.
Yeah.
But the thing is about important thing about weeds is that the reason why the grass is starting to come in is because the weeds have actually improved the soil. So that's what we tend to sort of forget. We focus on weeds and think we've got to get rid of them.
We've got to
pull them out of the soil and everything. We sort of work our way and pull them out and whatever, and then we might not even put them on the ground. We'll go and take them somewhere else.
Yeah.
But they're the experts at improving degraded soil. And they produce masses of seed. The seed has got really good dispersal abilities, so they can come into areas like this. The seed lasts a long time in the soil seed bank. And then when the conditions are right for the weeds to come up, they'll come up. And unfortunately, some of them are non-native, a lot of them, you know, not native species, and then we tend to freak out. But part of the reason why they're sort of, it's been easier for them to come and invade because of those weed-like characteristics. But, you know, you can spend a whole lot of time pulling them out. But the other thing that you can do is work with them. The experts at improving our soil are the soil organisms, the microbes and invertebrates in our soil.
Mm-hmm.
But to be able to do that job, they need the resources to do that job, the food to do that job. And so if we're pulling out the weeds and leaving bare ground, they've got nothing to eat.
So any type of vegetation is actually good vegetation.
Yep.
And I'm wasting my time pulling the weeds out.
Yep. But the other thing that's happening here is it's plants are always growing and losing roots. So we've got the organic matter from their root tissues. We've got the leaves. This is actually a lot of leaves from the tree above, but we've got the leaf litter from the plants,
mm-hmm.
and we've got those sugars again that mm-hmm. the plants are putting out through their
nutrients.
Roots.
Yeah.
And that, so given, and then if we've got a diversity of different weeds, all the better, because then we've got a diversity of different foods for the soil ecosystem, and then you're going to have a more diverse soil community, more diverse microbes, more diverse invertebrates, and you can see what's starting to happen now. This was all bare at one stage, and now what's coming in is the couch grass, and the grass is coming back, and that's because the weeds have done the job for us.
Right. So really, we need to ignore what we're used to seeing as untidy and embrace the weeds because of the beneficial effects that they have on the soil and the environment.
Yeah, being mindful about weeds that can be invasive into natural areas.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I mean, I'm not fussed about this, but you might want to cut the weeds before they seed.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
to so sort that's of the chop and drop.
That's the chop and drop. One, because you may not want as many, you might be sort of thinking, I don't want a whole lot of weed seeds, but also because by chopping and dropping, you're mimicking a grazing animal.
And so you're
bringing down all that stuff that you're chopping and dropping, you're bringing it down. So like these leaves, it's in contact with the soil, and so that it can then be part of the food source for the soil ecosystem.
Mm-hmm. And it's, excuse me. And when you chop and drop these seeds, it's creating another layer of homes for the animals above ground to live in and come and forage in.
Yeah, and yeah, good point. And also you're protecting, you're reducing the amount of water that runs off. You're reducing the amount of water that's lost from evaporation from the soil.
Yeah.
So it's a win-win situation, and you've all that time that you would have spent weeding, you can now get on and do more creative things.
Yeah, yes.